Hey guys, my name is BobLyn and welcome back to another video. This is the Des Moines video I was talking about and the third runner-up to the vote I put in my Discord. Now this is a big damage game and we have the space camo here on Des Moines. Now the graphics of my videos from now on will be improving and this is some of the gameplay I had recorded before my graphics improved. There was a BlueStacks update, so now my game looks way better, and for your guys' viewing pleasure, it will also be way nicer. But for now, we're gonna have to deal with these later gameplays, and yeah, it's only the best ones I'll upload, because I have some really good gameplay still laying around. Anyways, Des Moines, a really good cruiser, but I like to say old but gold. She is kind of forgotten, but she definitely hasn't been left out of the meta. And like last video of the Hindenburg, I'm going to try to explain my movements and my positioning. So to start out with here, we're going to move in and I see the CV. He is going to shoot his planes down the middle, of course. So I'm, you know, hoping to not get immediately spotted. Luckily, plane spotting is, you know, shorter than ship spotting. But here we go. We are spotted. And this is kind of a dangerous move to do because you are completely broadside to everybody. But I was hoping and guessing that I wasn't, because if you saw the team lineup, we were against a lot of tier 9s, and this is a perfect team lineup for Des Moines. Because Des Moines is a great HE spammer, and yeah, we're definitely going to farm some BBs in this game. And that's pretty much what you want to do with the Des Moines. You want to, if there's only BBs, you want to spam them with your HE, trying to use that rapid reload to get more fires, but You're first of all a cruiser, and that's why we have to take care of this Yugumo if we can. So we spot his torpedoes. Luckily, I think it was the DD who spotted them for me, which was nice. We were kind of in the danger zone there, but we dodged him. We managed. And now I'm just going to start spamming this FDG, because he is pushing like a madman, and I can't shoot at the Yugumo anyways. If you're looking at my positioning, I am completely bow on to the enemy team, or most of the enemy team, again. A very important tactic for a cruise player. But this FDG gets set on fire now, and the worst thing you can do in a situation like this where you're pushing as a BB or anything else for that matter, especially BBs since they are so healthy and tanky, is damage con on one fire when you're getting spammed. So now I am getting my first fire rapid reload up, and we just keep spamming this guy. He's even firing HE. So yeah, I guess I can consider myself lucky. This was a good target for me, and he kind of gave me all this damage. So, of course, I'm going to take it. There we go. He's on double fire, and you can just see my damage with this rapid reload is crazy. Des Moines AP is also nuts, and it gets citadels on pretty much everything. But the HE is what you need to use here. So, currently, my team is not doing too good. We have a lot of people outside the cap. We don't have any capture circles. But the enemy team is very pushed up, and as you can see, the FDG goes down to my fires there. We're already at 48k damage. I was just about to say 58, but we are not doing as bad as it might look because the enemy team are out of position. There's a Republic outside the cap, and the enemy team is kind of lemming training around. The next target up for me is the Prince Ruprecht and this side of the enemy push right here. We have to focus them and take them out because they're heavy targets. We need to take care of them. The gearing takes out the enemy DD, which is so good for me because now that means I'm pretty much safe to just sit here behind this rock and keep shooting. In a situation like this, as a cruiser player, you do not want to push out. There's also this Neptune, but I mean, these guys are just making it easy, right? There's no reason for me to push closer. They're not even shooting at us. Like, there's no reason for us to, you know, get closer. Now the Neptune, though, he is starting to shoot, and the enemy team have noticed me, because we've taken out the Ruprecht. Now it's time for me to kite. So instantly, when this happens, when the enemy team decides that you are the next target, instantly get in a kiting position, because it's better to have your rear against the enemy team so you can get away fast, than have your front and having to go full broadside to actually get away. Because look at that, that's a Republic, FDG, Neptune, and yeah, we don't want to give too much broadside to that. The FDG is pretty much going down here because he is on a double fire, and yeah, there's no way out for him. But he actually got his damage control up, I think, at the last second, so we fire our AP salvo away because I'm going to use AP for this Neptune. And this is where you have to be really good at swapping ammo types in your ship, because using the wrong ammo type in, you know, clutch situations can be very, very, very detrimental. Luckily, our Preussen completely annihilates that Neptune, which, I mean, it just demonstrates the power of 12 guns. And now we are in a dangerous position against the Republic, who's chasing me down, and we are very low HP. I'm not running Halsey on this commander, on this ship, sorry, but I don't really need that, because look at that, into his deck right there, where the Republic is not really well armored. I'm pretty sure it's just 32mm, or sorry, 30mm even. I'm pretty sure it's pretty bad armor, because look at that, we got our third Citadel. Now we're healing, we might actually have a chance, but he's turning around to get all his guns off, but that is it. 131k damage. And a lot of that is because the enemy team was pretty, I won't say a foul word, but they weren't the smartest, because pushing in like that, you know, when there's a Des Moines or any cruiser who can shoot fast and has somewhat, you know, decent armor, is dangerous. It's very dangerous, and that's where a cruiser can be probably the best ship in the whole game, is when people push in, especially the American cruisers. So I hope you guys, you know, learned something from that. I really want to try to explain more what, you know, what I do in games, because sometimes, you know, I just do stuff and it just, I don't really think about it. But Des Moines, you know, even though I didn't get any planes this game, Des Moines has amazing AA, and you can see that you get a defensive fire too, which, trust me, Des Moines is decent at killing planes. There we go. But that was the game. I'm going to show you guys my build now, of course, at the end of the game, for those of you guys who are interested, so let's check that out. So, for the Des Moines Elite Bonus, it's kind of weird, man. It doesn't buff the guns, it buffs the tankiness, and I chose the internal bulkhead because 1% ship HP is pretty good, I guess. It gives it a little bit. I have the space camo, which, in my opinion, is the best one, since you get firing range and shell dispersion, but the historical camo one also gives range, which is kind of nice, and it buffs the AA, so I guess it's also good. I used to have the historical camo and was happy with it. I got legendary mod, which boosts range and decreases your reload, increases your reload time. It's a nerf to reload, but I still have it. I like the extra range, and then you can see I run a standard cruiser build for my commander, standard commander, level 11. And yeah, there's not really much to say, except I take, as you can see, I take Survivalist instead of an extra rapid reload, because I think you get enough on Des Moines. I mean, it's enough for me at least. It's you know, Des Moines, it's without the rapid reloads, you still deal quite a lot of damage. Just by having two or threes that shoot so fast, 6 seconds is pretty quick. Without the legendary mod, you have 6 second reload, which is very, very good for 203s. That's it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed. I honestly think Des Moines is a really good cruiser, and it's definitely an old built gold. It's not power crept. It's just as good as it was when it, you know, the game was released. I haven't played back then, but at least I think so. My name has been BobLyn, and I am signing out.